What's up, everybody? Welcome to the live stream, Make It Songbringer, or perhaps the archive of the live stream on YouTube. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Hello. Today I'm working on this Rockface guy some more, and I've been refining the meditation animations. It's pretty cool. This animation is looking a lot better. Today I'm going to be making it so there can be three different rock faces. All of them give you a different item. And I'm going to work on the dialogue too. The dialogue is just the way the words come in doesn't really look that good to me. So I want to work on the timing of all that. Hey, Teeks! What's up? What's up? And yeah, that's all I'm working on. Just working on this this rock face guy and the items you get from him and the timing of the dialogue and all that. So then there's gonna be multiple of these different rock faces you can find throughout the overworld. So that's what I'm working on first, is the being able to find multiple of them, and then each one of them will give you this a Sarira, which is an item. So you have a little token that you actually, you did this or whatever in the overworld, you accomplished this little thing. Yes, you found a way for Twitch to not buffer? That's great. What's that? What's the way? Don't tell me, turn it off. Okay, so each one of these different, there's three different story nodes. Each one of these story nodes is now going to have its own dedicated Sarira item. And then this is going to be... put these, I'll connect these with pluses. So I'm gonna need to create a special type of dialogue. There's a script called Live Streamer that lets you open Twitch streams and VLC player. Sweet. And that solves the buffering. That's great. Wow. I'm gonna tell everybody that. So yeah, it's gonna trigger all those dialogues that'll look like that. But I need to write that first, so I need to get the first bits here. So this is going to give you item Sarira 1. And you have to not have Sarira 1 for this to be triggered. We want to save on complete. Yes, no more buffering. That's great. That's like legendary great. Has no Sarira 2. Item Sarira 2. So hey, Teek, how's the new game coming? How long do they take to review an application? It can be kind of hit or miss with Humble. Sometimes they're real speedy, sometimes they're not. But for me at first, what happened to me was that I filled out the wrong form with Humble, and I was waiting like 2 weeks or whatever. And I was like, man, they never replied. I thought they were just like ignoring me, but I had filled out the wrong form. So, with Humble, I would say just like apply. And then if you don't get a reply, try again. They're usually pretty fast. I mean, you know, but they're kind of hit or miss. I found that now that I have everything established with Humble, I have a certain guy at Humble that I know will reply, and he's always on the ball. So whenever I have any kind of questions, I always ask him. So it might be that way for you. It might not be that way for you. I don't know. Oh, dang. So you sold zero copies so far and got no exposure on Itch? Dang, man. What about getting some exposure other ways, like Twitter? Serrera 3, Serrera 3. Okay, let's make sure the player doesn't have any rock face. Nope. And Serrera. No Serrera. Okay, so let's just make sure the first thing still works. Working on it. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. So let's make sure this still is functioning. Okay, next thing I want to make it so if you have multiple Serrera in your inventory, they show up as different quantities of the same item. So you could have three Serrera and we just have one item with a quantity three. What does the Serrera do? I'm thinking about making them so once you collect all the Serrera, it becomes one of the armors. So there's like five different armors that will be in the game. There's like poison armor, ice armor, fire armor, and all the elements. And then so you collect all the Serrera and it becomes one of those armors. Or it just might be a collectible item. So this is something you would have to do to get 100% of the game. I don't know. It's probably more fun to make it so that it actually becomes an armor. See what happens if I just have two of them in my inventory already. What's up, a fool's duty? Yep, still working on Songbringer. It's going really well. When I started Songbringer, I had no idea it would all turn out this well. It's just all gone so incredible. I'm so happy for all the support everyone's given to the project from the Kickstarter to the current people backing it and by pre-ordering and stuff. It's just great. It's really, really, really great. It's good to be doing exactly what I love. This is exactly what I would want to do. This is my dream game. I'm doing it exactly how I want. It's amazing. How about yourself, a fool's duty? What you doing, man? How's it going? Okay, so they're not doubling up yet. Let's get me in phase gear, which loads interfaces gear. And here's where it skips ahead an item or two sometimes. Another positive side effect. You always have the quality select that normally is only available. Oh, that's awesome. Dang, Teek. You found it, man. That's awesome. Fool's duty, you're just hanging out, watching everyone on the game dev? Like butterflies, except less creepy. Isn't that great? It's totally like that, huh? It's totally like that. I am still crawling out of my chrysalis. As soon as Songbringer is released, I think I will officially be a butterfly. We'll see. We'll see. It depends. There's no guarantees of success or anything. So we need one of these here. Is Serrera. And we'll do items. Serrera 1. Num Serrera. Oh, damn it. We need a function for this. Count the Serira. Baby, what's up?
I'm streaming.
Yeah, it's been cold today. Oh, you wish you had the upload speed to live stream? Well, I'll tell you something. I have some of the worst upload speed ever. Used to have really good upload speed, and then my internet company just changed somehow, and then I could never get good internet since then. So, I don't know. I only need, like, I'm pretty sure I stream at 1,500. Yeah, see, I'm looking at this. I'm at about 1,500. So if your upload speed is like 2 to 2.5, you should be all right. I can send you my settings and everything. I'll even show it right now in case there's anybody watching this on YouTube or whatever. You're like, what? What kind of settings do you have? I'm telling you, this took weeks and months of trying different stream things. Here's my settings. This is a little less than half the screen size. Half the screen size would be 800 for me, but I made it 720. So it's just barely HD. Frames per second, 15. Trying to set the average bit rate, 1250. Sort of low quality. But these are the key important settings to have for streaming, at least for encoding X264. You got to set your VBV max rate and your VBV buff size. And then make sure everything else is set up too. You have your keyframes and all that. How Twitch likes it. Dang, you only have 70k a second? Oh, yeah, that's not enough. Dang, man. So I'm working on some functions and stuff for gaining this little Serira item you get when you meditate next to Rockface. Then I'm gonna work on his dialogue so he looks better, sounds better. Oh, this is what we'll need one of these too. Count. The Serira. Is Serira. Count Serira. Count Serira, ha ha ha. Alright, so then back here to interfaces. If it's Serira, count. I don't think this is necessary here. Your neighbors get 100 megabits? Wow, how does your neighbors do that? I wish I had that great of a connection. I have to pay like 80 bucks a month, and I still don't even have that great of a connection as far as upload speed goes. But gosh, here in the States, the internet companies are really like monopolistic and just like unchanging. Not very good for customers. There we go. Now we got two Serira, quantity. So what is a Serrera? I hear you asking. Someone out there, you're curious, huh? Aren't you? You're curious. A Serrera is a crystal purportedly found in the ashes of a cremated guru. They're purportedly found in many, many gurus' ashes. This is what a Serrera is. But here in the game, it's just a pearly thing, because it's from Rock's perspective, and he's just a kid. He's just a boy. He's just a young 20-year-old, 30-year-old boy, something like that. Okay, so we're trying to meditate here, and since we already have this rear one, it's not doing it. Okay, next thing I want to do is have the rock face light up his face if you have already attained the Serrera item. What's up, Ghetto Dev? Ghetto Dev! Ghetto Dev! Okay, so when we create... What's an NPC tile? This is where we create Rockface. Okay, so Rockface has a conditional glow. Let's just call it that. Rockface has a conditional glow. Basically, if contains name Rockface. We want to see if we already have the Serrera for that particular Rockface. So the item type will be K item Serrera 1 plus pattern minus K pattern rock face 1. That'll have to give us the right item. Check it with the breakpoint. And then if we already have this item, if we have the hero, nope, we have no hero here. Game scene, hero, 0, dot, gear, dot, count, item, greater than 0. Then we are going to add the glow. So the glow let's do a sprite. Hopefully we could do this in one line without even having to, let's try this, sprite. No, we're gonna need to at least make it. Wait, is there some way we could make this so? I was wondering how I could make this data driven. I could put this something in the entities data that's like, if you have this item, then you have this certain child node. If you don't have the child, if you don't have the item, then the child node is not created. Huh. Data-driven. That would be so much better than this, huh? I should just dive in and do it the data-driven way, huh? What's up, Kosage? 5 US monthly fee in Poland? What? That's great. Oh, you built your houses? Oh, cool, man. You did it all yourself. Because the cables. Dang it. Oh, but in 2 years you're all getting fiber. Yeah, that's awesome. Wow. Okay. So check it. Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna do this the data-driven way, not the code way. Rockface is gonna have a child. This is the glow. Render component. Image. Rock face one glow. This is additive, and its position should just be zero, I think. Okay, let's see if that worked, and then we can add the conditional bit that makes it so you have to have an item for that to be blah blah blah. Whoa, 40, so you pay 45 euro for 100 megabits? God damn, I'm getting raped here in the United States. Paying $80 a month for something like, I think we're supposed to get 60 megabits or something like that. Hey, it worked on the first try. Can you believe it? Can you believe it? It worked on the freaking first try? What the hell is this? Something must be wrong. My programmer instinct's going crazy right now. Oh, the glow's a little bit. It's not above it. It needs to be below. Below, you need to go below. Below, 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 below. So you order mid minus 30, just like, well, let's go mid minus 29. Because I want mid minus 30. And then we're going to add this conditional bit right here. So it's going to be require. I'm going to make this up. It's called require item sarira 1. Okay, so it's not going to do anything yet, but we're going to add that code to do that. Oh, at least in the city. So, do you live in the city or do you live outside the city? There we go. Now we're on top of the glow. That looks a lot better. Same thing over here. Yeah, good. All good. All good. All good. Yeah. I'm really liking how the bloom is starting to look now. Now that the player doesn't glow too brightly, everything is like, it's just only a few things that have this nice glow, super sweet bloom. Okay, so require item, let's make that happen. I think this is going to be in create entity. When you first create the entity with the data and all that. Area creation. Oh, you live inside, but at the border. You have your own private forest just in front of your window. Oh my God, dude. That's like my dream. My dream is to walk outside my back door and just be able to go hiking right there in the wild. That's one of my dreams. I got a lot of dreams, I guess. Okay. Oh yeah, create. What is this? Area creation. Here's where we want to be. Auto entity. That's where we grab the data and all that. Create entity. This is where it is. Create entity. We want to just return zero right here. If the thing has the data and the player doesn't have that. Okay, so require item, we're gonna make this like technically it'll be kind of like that. But that is the equivalent of that. So basically we're requiring one Sarira one. But if you don't put one, it just insinuates. What's the right word for that? Extrapolates, interpolates. Okay. So require item equals data dot get child require item digester. Now if we have this, blah, 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 blah. We're gonna do some stuff here. It's not that big, but it's big enough. The properties with the family since the time when the ground here was worth like nothing. Now all your neighbors are medics? Wow. So you live in a nice area. That's cool. Germany, you guys are doing some cool stuff in Germany. You guys really are. You guys are like leading the passive house movement. You guys have like really great wind power and solar power. I'm excited for you, for what you guys are building over there. You're building a cool world. Okay, so we're gonna parse this into words. Vector string, words. Split up require item by delimiter space into words. Yeah, new tech. So cool. So this item string is either word zero or nothing. This will just make it safe in case there are no words. And then the quantity is going to be similar here. Words that size is greater than or equal to 2, then it's going to be parse int words 1. Otherwise, 1 implied. Okay. And then now we come to the crux of it all. If game scene hero 0.gear.count. Oh, we need to parse the item. Okay, let's change this up. This will be item type, item. This is gonna be parse item type. How did I do that? Using the bicycle is like no existence in the US. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, you guys have bikes everywhere. Totally, all over Europe. Yeah, it pretty much here in the United States, there are people that bicycle. Yeah, there's definitely people that are doing their part to bicycle and for the planet and all that. I'm one of them. I don't have a car. I ride my bicycle when I need to go places most of the time. I do drive a car a lot too. So the thing is, yeah, in the United States, we have so many cars. And everybody drives their car pretty much everywhere. What's up, Boogie? How's it going, man? Yo. I think this is going to be constants. Get item type? Yeah, get item type. From word zero. Otherwise, this is just k-item none. There, now we can see if we have the item. And, okay, so if it's less than the quantity, then we're returning zero. We're not even going to create this entity. Now let's set a breakpoint and see if it works. What's going on today? I'm working on this NPC called Rockface. You encounter him 3 times in the game on the overworld. He's an overworld NPC. He's a big old obelisk, and you meditate next to him to gain like knowledge of the of the world, of the planet, and the races of people that make up the Songbringer universe. So I'm working on his interaction, this dialogue, the items you get from him, and mostly just dialogue. I'm working on the dialogue component so it can look like different for him and have make different sounds, proceed at a different speed and all that. You'll see in a second, once I get this little bit of code finished, you'll see the picture of him. Oh, actually here. Here's what he looks like. This is Rockface with his glow. There's without his glow. The glow looks a lot cooler in the game because it's all additive glowing. So this becomes more white, but slightly pink, purple. So yeah, you meditate next to this dude. You gain his knowledge. Okay, so we're parsing out Rockface. Are we? Where is this at? Create entity. That's quite the rock face. Yeah, we were talking about this last time. I was like, no, not that kind of rock face. Require item. All right, so it's requiring item. It's not letting me know, but who cares? Words, split it into words. Let's see how many words we got. What words? One word, Sarira, one. Great. Parse that out into item type. Becomes not that item. Where's the, oh, here we go. Yeah, it came Sarira one. Very good. Cool. Quantity one. All right, now if game scene hero gear count item is less than quantity, meaning it would be zero, we return zero. Cool, so it's gonna do this. It's gonna add this child. I think, okay, so let's make sure it all works. Let's do require item, well, no, let's go change the quantity so we no longer have this and it should create the glow. So I'm making something data-driven here. This is cool. It's very cool to make anything at all possible data-driven. So if I meditate here, good. So he's gonna meditate. That means the whole action's running and you're gonna get this item and all that. Good, okay, so he didn't start with the glow that time. Get the Sarira. Go off screen. And if I come back this time, I should have the Sarira. So it should have the glow. Yes, it worked. Dang, made it data driven that fast. That's so cool. Now I can make any entity whenever I'm making an entity or whatever. I can make it require an item. So this child of this item here, I'm only adding this one glowing sprite if it has this item. Let's make it like unattainable. There's no way to even get to Sarira's. So let's make sure this fails. Let's make sure that parses and behaves. That code behaves as it should. Okay, so it's gonna parse this as words. Yeah, it's got two words this time, that's good. And then we should have item, Sarira quantity two, good. This time it should fail, return zero. There's no way you're gonna get this, cool. And then even if I meditate, it shouldn't, and I'll get this item. There'll be three quantity in my inventory. That's three different items. Face with the glow the next time I come back on this screen. Oh, damn it. Something didn't work. Okay, why? Let's make sure Let's just go ahead and set the quantity to 1 right away. And then we'll check it one more time. So straight up going right into the game, it should not allow this. It should return 0 here. Good, it is. Maybe it was just left over. It must have just been left over. So if I go off the screen here, come back. Cool. So what could be leaving? That glow. That's created in use meditate. Maybe there's something wrong with that. Here's where we animate rock face. And the sprite becomes a child of rock face. His render.sprite, which should delete this sprite as soon as the As soon as it leaves the area. So what do I confirm first? Let's try turning off Sarira. Let's put this back to how it should be. I just want to make sure that it's deleting this sprite. So how can I verify that? We need to create the sprite first. So we need to do the meditate, go off the screen, come back. And it should be gone. Well, so that means that basically I just need to turn off this child, all these children completely. Okay. Okay, let's test this out. I should be able to meditate. The glow should appear. I go off the screen, come back, the glow should be gone. Sounds logical. I saw it disappear right there. It's gone. It's totally gone. So let's turn it back on here. Make sure your player doesn't have it. Cool. Okay, so everything's back as it was. Maybe it was because I had that quantity 2 in there, something like that. Yeah, I totally saw it disappear. Okay, this time I'm gonna make it so it doesn't even animate this Rockface's glow at all when he does the meditate. And this time I should be able to get the Sarira, go off the screen, come back, and it should just suddenly appear. A glow should appear that time. I'm not gonna mess with this anymore. All right, I'm checking this in so far. This is good. We have a this is sweet. Conditional way to do children. So create NPC tile. I think I have some code I started writing there I don't need anymore. I already deleted it. Cool. Let's make sure this check in here this commit is clean. So I added that child to Rockface, the glow. I reworked the story items so that each different rock face has its own dedicated item that you obtain. Added the necessary functions so that those items can be combined sort of, or visually they will look as if they're one item. Oh, those need to be all quantity one now. Actually, you could probably put it as quantity two. Well, let's put it as one for now. Now two will make it so we can craft it. I'm thinking that you're going to be able to, either you craft it or they just automatically combine. Kind of would be cooler if you crafted them. So you find the three Sarira, and then you can craft all three of them somehow into a... Yeah, let's do that. Craftable. Depletable. I don't know if it needs this equipable of depleted flag. I'm gonna give it that anyway. So it's gonna be passive. Craftable. No, it's just a passive craftable depletable. I think this is supposed to be how it should be. Now I'm just checking over my code to make sure I didn't make any stupid mistakes, which happen all the time, unless you check your work. At least in my own personal experience. That's why it also really helps to have different colors than you normally code in. Like I normally code in these colors or whatever, and then I come here and I can review it in different colors, which helps my brain think a little bit differently and be like, oh, this is different. Is this all right? Did all of these code edits, did I make any mistakes? So it really helps me to have different colors here. K item Serira plus one plus I item. Count Serira is Serira to that. Looks good. All right, next thing I want to do with Rockface is to make him so he has sequential dialogue. So the first Rockface you encounter always gives you the first bit of the dialogue, even though you get a certain item. It's and that Rockface is technically Rockface 1. It might play Rockface 2 if you've already found another Rockface in the world. So the way I'm going to do that, a new format for running dialogue. It's going to look like this. Separated by pluses. I already got something where I'm separating by commas, which means it chooses one at random. And if they're all strung together with pluses, that's going to mean run them sequentially. Meaning if you've already done this certain dialogue, wait a minute, how are we going to do that? I might have to rethink this. Because there's no way that the code would know that you've done Rockface 1. Wait a minute, I think the code was all right before. Holy crap. I don't think I have to do anything here. So if we have Rockface 1. That's gonna run before Rockface 2. Oh, no. This needs to be different because Rockface 2 could potentially play Rockface 1's dialogue. Oh, I got it. Okay, so this is... We're going to have three of each one of these. So Rockface 1. This runs dialogue Rockface 1 if you... that's wrong too. This is a really tricky one. How to get it so it can play three different kinds of dialogue, but have the exact same three different items. Oh man, I thought I could just go like Face one, rock face two, face three. Oh, if I take away these, then we can only trigger this once. What's up, Mutinous? Is there no way to tally checks, or can it reference story items you're holding? Yeah, it does reference story items you're holding. So that's what I was just really removing this save for, because Rockface 1... As soon as it runs this story action right here, this node, it will save, because I removed this save on complete thing, it's gonna save this into your save game, into the story. So this is the story block right here. There's all these different story items which have already run. So yes, it tallies it basically. It says as soon as it runs that, it puts Rockface, like Rockface 1 in here, right? The trick is just making it so it can work a little differently than the way the usual system works, in that it always runs a certain dialogue in order. Wait a minute, I already did this. I did this for something else. Yeah, I did it for the swordless. Swordless ones. How did those work? I think it's this swordless one. Oh yeah, it's straight up action. That's really simple. Huh. Okay, well, let's see if this works now. If we have Rockface, so this will now save Rockface 1's dialogue. Yeah, this works differently than that, though. This works differently than anything else yet so far. So we would want it to sequentially, like, okay, so first, the first one of these you get, you would run this first dialogue, because you didn't have Rockface 1 already. I thought I figured this out last night, and I was like, oh, I'm just going to do that. And then now it's a little trickier than that. I guess I could custom craft the way this dialogue works. It's really how it's gonna have to be. So we're gonna put like a no save on all of these. And then this dialogue is gonna have to work like this. And then this special thing right here is gonna know that, okay, the first time it runs this, it's gonna run Rockface 1 because it hasn't saved Rockface 1 to this story. And then, but that's how it's gonna work. This special thing right here will set Rockface 1. No, this needs to be called Rockface. Just Rockface. Well, actually, let's keep them as they were just in case they're. So then we'll have these special story nodes here, so it can save these. I guess that now we don't need to have the no save. We're gonna have the special text, and we have to go into strings here. And make all these 1A, 2A, 3A. Okay, so now to make this work. It's like sequential dialogue, I guess, is kind of the way to think of it. Action dialogue. I think there was something that already parsed it out. Here it is, get dialogue lines. Yeah. Okay. So it's gonna be kind of like this, where it separates out or parses a list of different potential keys it could run, and then this one chooses one at random. But what we really want to do with this is to choose one sequentially. So if we haven't this one, and we do the first one first if possible, basically, and then we also have to set these. Set these story nodes or whatever as if they had been run. So this is choose a random key. If contains val, comma. Let's choose a random key. Now we're going to have choose a sequential key. So for each key in the keys we parsed, if we don't already have that story node marked as complete, what the hell is that function I have to call? It's been a minute since I've dealt with the story system here. It's not can run action. It's not status. Oh, it's data. I think it's like has data or something. There it is, has data. And then I've also got set data. Okay, so if we do not have data for that key, then this is the key we want to run. Key equals K, and also set data. So as soon as we choose one of these sequential keys, we want to set it. Savable, unsaved, I think. Man, it's been a minute. I want to make sure all this works. Set a breakpoint at least there. Case save, is it savable, unsaved? Well, obviously not. I think it's just savable. Yeah, savable is normal. No saves never. Save on complete. Save on music complete. And then, but what the hell is unsaved? I don't know. I think it's just savable. All right, let's hope the hell this works. Eh? I hope this works. Gosh, this is a lot of like thought work to get this one to work. Okay. Starting off, I have no Sarira. I shouldn't have any story nodes. Let's just verify that. Story, is there any rock face in here? No rock face. All right, we got no story items. Running this, so it should figure out that we're running a sequential dialogue, and it should go, oh, I should run the first one because you haven't done any of the other ones. There, okay, so it's about to run this key. Let's see what it parsed. Keys, yes, it's got the three different keys it could run. We're gonna loop over these. The first one is going to be Rockface 1A, and it doesn't have that, so that's going to be our key, and then we're going to set data. Right. Okay. So it's saved. Savable is saved. Yeah. Oh, unsaved is just where it starts. That's zero. Oh, okay. So clearly that was just supposed to be case savable, and this should be fine now. I set this to run one more, it's gonna. Oh, it should break. Because this is gonna now go and run the key again and again and again. It's gonna run all three keys. So that was broken. We need a break here. It was broken because we didn't break. It was broken because we didn't break. Where are the quote masters when you need them? Quote me on this. Right, this time we should run the first dialogue. First dialogue. Yes. Thanks, Boogie. Yes. Oh, I feel so accomplished now. There's a quote of the day. So if I save and quit now, we should have rock face and all that. Okay, good. This time it saved rock face 1 and rock face 1A. Is that what I want? It's what I want. It's what I want. It's what I want. Okay, so let's take off Sarira 2. No, wait. Let's say we had. Yeah. It doesn't really matter. If we take off Sarira 1, we should be able to re-enable this guy. So I should be able to. If I had gone to a different rock face before this, I could have triggered that first dialogue potentially. And we come here and do it again, and we would have the second dialogue appear. We should see the second dialogue in the sequence this time. Yes, it's the second dialogue. So great. It should give me the second Serira. Oh, it didn't give me any Serira. Why not? Oh, it did. It did give me the second Serira. Oh, it must have just been the phase item didn't have any text for the dialogue, maybe. Okay, let's run that action again. So I'm gonna need to take off rock phase 2 and 2A. This time when we go to phase item. We want to go and make sure it's got text to run stuff. Where is that text? Oh, it is parse text key. And filter item type. That's probably it. Thank you. I saved the game. I thought it gave me the second item. It's so weird. Gave me Rockface 2 and 2A. And it totally gave me the second item again. But it didn't even trigger phase item. Oh, I think I know what it is. It's an action item right here in the story system. Pretty sure there's another check for if the words are empty. Yeah. Yeah, here it is. This needs to be constants. Filter. Wait. No, that could break. That could break a lot. If text dot empty, let's try again with constants filter item type. So what that's doing is it's basically taking Serira 2 and filtering it down to Serira 1 for its item text. It's just reusing text. Okay, so we want to go 0 there and then take off these two from the story. Do it again. This time we should have some dialogue. Water. Yeah. Yes, we got the Serira that time. Beautiful. Free parking. Got Borisonville. Legendary old Borisonville with the most points of anybody. You're a legend, man. Legend. Serira, this time, 2. Oh, that's because we didn't. Hold on. Has he or hasn't he? I don't know. He just might be the best lurker ever. Yeah, look, Al Borisonville is more than Steve Tranby. Yes, the water of life. It is actually water I'm drinking. There's literally nothing else in this except for water. Just water in this water. And sparkles. There's sparkles in the water too, I guess. Sparkling water. Right? So Al Borisonville is either the most legendary lurker ever. He's like the best lurker that's ever graced our planet. Or he's like a bot or somebody that's just there to get points. I don't know. Okay, let's make sure this all works now in order. So I should be able to like run to each one. I'll run to them in different order. Let's look at the map. Let's look at the map for Xanadu. Let's make sure this all works if I do it in sequence. That would be, I think it's one, wait, it's 2, 5, and 9. There they are. There's 2, 5, and 9. Okay, I want to do them in reverse order to make sure this does work. I need to have no Serira. Serira is a funny word to say. Sounds kind of weird, flowing off the tongue. Maybe he died. Oh, don't say that. From seeing all the bad habits. He paid years of internet service in advance. What's up, Proton Gaming? How's it going, man? Right, let's do this. Let's do this. I want to make sure I'm doing this in like reverse order. Oh, also I want to just double check that I got the story notes correct. Rockface 1. Yep, all these rock faces. Rockface 2, 302, 302, but all these 3, 3, 3, all those. Looks good. Let's do this. Dang, a clone geek, you got a lot of points. You got enough to just win a free game right now. You already have the game? Because literally, all you gotta do is execute one little swift command and you have a guaranteed. It's only 100 points. You only have 100 points to go and you have guaranteed. Right now, you have a 99% chance of winning the raffle. But yeah, 100 more points and you have, is it, I think it's 100. Yeah, it's 4,000. You have 3,919. Where's number 9? I think number 9's right here to the, there we go. Number 9. What's up, number 9? You're not risking the 1% chance a failure. I'm not gonna risk it. You can't make me. Oh, there you go. There you go. Now you definitely got a 100% chance. One down, and that's great because this was actually Rockface number 3, but he did dialogue number 1. Confirming things. Confirm. Here's Rockface number 2, and it should actually run. Let's do Rockface number 1 now, because that was Rockface 2, and we're gonna try dialogue 2. It's just so wrong. We need to be like trying rock. Whoa, where the hell is he? Where are you? Shout if you can hear me. Marco! Yes! Oh, Clone Geek, you won! Woo! Congrats, man! Yeah! You got a copy of the game now. All you gotta do is email me. Email me and I'll send you the code after the stream. Make sure Sala said put my email address here. Nat at Wizard Foo. There you go. Send me an email. I'll send you your Steam key. Congratulations, Clone Geek. Studiously saving up your points for this very moment. You did just do it at 3.99. That was a great, great time. Okay, so this is Rock Face number 1. It should give us dialogue number 2. You collect 10,000 points. Yeah, you would. You deserve something for that, man. Oh, great. That's great. Thanks, Clone Geek. I appreciate that. That's a good way to do it. I should say that every time. Send me a Twitch message just so I can verify your email. Good call. Very good call. Oh, it didn't do its lit upness here. But it did do the right dialogue number. Let's see if number 3 works. Where the hell is it? Here we go. Most points wasted. Souls lost to the points that they lost. Oh, hey, this one lit up. Why didn't the other one light up? This one still lit up. This one's lit up. They're all lit up now. That's great. We have 3 Serrera. They all went in order. Oh, this is awesome. I think it's working. But the only thing that didn't work was with that one that didn't light up when I came back on the screen. What is that? Proton, lifestyle question. Do you follow a strict diet or have you always watched what you eat? That's a good question. That's a really good question. Thanks, Wolfrock. Yeah, that's a really great question because I really feel that diet affects your creativity strongly. And being a game developer, I am required to have a lot of creativity all the time. Every day I need to be creating something. You know, it's like constant creative process. So yeah, I've always had a pretty good diet. I watch what I eat really well. I've swung and had times where I've been bad diet, but for the most part, I try and eat like, you know, whole foods. That's really just the simple way to put it. You know, I don't eat things out of packages as much as possible. And also, I'm learning how to do the right things, like how to cook your own rice, how to cook your own beans. You got to soak them, you know. If you don't soak them, there's like, you get problems. But basically, the whole point is, yeah, I watch what I eat. And I do yoga pretty much every day. I do a little bit of yoga and I do meditation every night. So every night before I go to bed, I light a little candle right there, right on the floor right there. I just light a little candle and sit and meditate for a little while. And it actually is probably some of the most just profoundly helpful times for creating the game. Because insights come to me like crazy good when I'm meditating. Yeah, I hope that helps. Wolfrock, thanks, man. I appreciate you saying that. It's also cheaper to cook yourself. Totally, right? It's much cheaper to cook your own rice than it is to go and buy rice that's already made. Same thing with beans. Same thing with pretty much anything. Just eat real foods. It's a pretty simple thing, you know? Okay, I'm going to check this in so far. This is a good move. And I'm going to try and figure out why that one guy didn't light up. Don't cook yourself. It hurts. Meditating is really tough for you. There's so many distractions. Yeah, I hear you. Feels like you're missing out. You're not doing something important, but otherwise you'd just be mindlessly surfing Reddit. Yeah. It is kind of hard to get into the habit of meditating, but For me, it was like kind of like learning how to play a guitar. Like for me, the first 6 months of trying to play a guitar were horrible. I hated it. I was like, man. I mean, I kind of liked it because it was, you know, a nice little thing to hear music and stuff. But like, I was really bad at playing guitar for a long time. And then all of a sudden, like 6 months into it, I had this breakthrough moment or whatever. And all of a sudden, it became a lot easier to play guitar, and it became very pleasant to play guitar. It's the same thing with meditating. As soon as you have that breakthrough moment, you just kind of get it. You kind of understand. You understand how to put you. It's really it's how to lower your brain waves or raise your brain waves or whatever. You're basically just changing the frequency of your own brain. And as soon as you learn how to do that, and it becomes something that you're good at, I think it'll be more enjoyable and easier for you to get in that groove. You know, it's like, I don't know. I recommend kind of toughing it out and just trying to do it. Just do it. Do it every night. Even if you're not, even if you don't feel like you're actually doing it well, just do it anyways. That's my recommendation. If that's something you which you want, you know, if it's one of your goals in life is to meditate, I highly recommend it. The problem with cooking yourself is you can only do it once. You just get drunk. Barefoot wine's pretty nice, huh? Barefoot, they make a good wine. Okay, this is the sequential dialogue check-in. All right. I need to go back to the state that it was right before. I think it didn't do. Oh, I didn't even save. Okay, we gotta do this over again. All right. Well, let's make sure this is okay, it's ready to go. Oh, this is that lower, this is the first one. So let's make sure. Well, let's go up to the third one. Rockface 3. Well, it's Entity Rockface 1. That's why it's not working. Because the require item's not the right thing. So if I whoop, if I go off the screen here, come back, it'll have it because we don't have require item 1. So this is just entities. We need multiple rock faces. We're going to need a require item 1. Require item Serrera 1 and all that. Before I do that, I think it'd be good to flesh this out and make one more little adjustment so Rockface can have a shadow. This will be cool. All right, Rockface, you're getting a shadow now. So he's gonna have a shadow that's like select all that. Let's put a layer behind everything. I guess it could be black or white. I guess black would be preferable. And I want it to be like this. All that, but not the rest. So if you turn that off, you can see. Yeah, so it should look about like this. It's like dropping a huge load. Yes. That's a good way to put it. It's like dropping a huge load. Dropping some kids off at the pool, man. So this, making it like this is going to make it so the shadow looks right, even though it looks weird here on the, like this, should look right. But it's gonna need it's to be trimmed, so we'll do it like this, and then save this as not backgrounds. We gotta put this into shadow. This is Rockface shadow. This is actually gonna take up a little bit of room here in the sprite sheet. Let's make sure this is working. Oops. Oh, totally. Fits fine. All right, Rockface. You get in a shadow. Okay, so now he's always going to have a shadow child. And it's going to be up a bit. How much? How much? How many things do you blah, blah, blah? It's a total of about 28 pixels high. So 0.28, 0, render image rock face shadow, and then give it a shadow with no offset. We'll see if that works. I've never employed this technique before to put a shadow for something huge like this. Okay, does it have a shadow? It might. It's definitely the wrong Z order. So we want mid. Oh, wait. Z order. Mid minus 31. At least 30, 50, whatever. So that should put it behind, and then we want to go to the hour of the day where we can see shadows a little bit clearer. Or maybe just we'll turn on, yeah, let's do both. Do 0 there. Oh, you've already done it before? Oh, okay. It's just starting again. I hear you. I totally hear you on that. God, I was so long. There was so many times, like, for years, I was the same way. I was like, I had done meditation before. I knew how awesome it was, but it was so hard for me to start the habit again. And then recently, I just got into it again, and somehow it just became really easy to drop myself into the habit, and it worked for me at that point. But I understand, man. I understand. Looks like it needs to come in about 6 pixels or something. Probably with the alignment of the image or something. Because the rock face himself is a certain width because he's got the other stuff around him, and then this thing doesn't have that other stuff around. About 1 more pixel. And let's check, let's do the whole daylight thing. So see how that looks. That's what you're blaming it on? Nice, right on. That's pretty great, dude. You're 18 years old and you already know how to meditate? That's awesome. I don't think I learned until I was like 25 or 26 or something. Alright, cool. Rockface has a shadow and it looks good. That technique works. Okay, so next time I have a huge entity like this that's really big and takes up most of the screen, I can do a shadow mask like this. Let's see that at regular daylight speed, because it looks a little bit weird when it's like going fast. Oh, I am old. I'm getting older day by day. What's up, clock? All right, yay, we got shadow component. Yeah, why am I not in the shadow? This is such a big entity, I should be in that shadow, but I'm not gonna rewrite the whole system just for that yet. Yes, this is cool. All right, we got a shadow. And one more thing, now that we have Rockface all complete, we need 3 Rockfaces. Rockface 1, 2, and 3. And when we create the NPC tile, create them individually, so later on I could go and change the artwork if necessary. Hey, see ya, Boogie. Thanks for jumping by, man. I know the tree shadow behind it looks weird, doesn't it? We had this conversation on stream a while ago about do shadows add up, and apparently they do, but not if a giant entity is already casting a shadow on top of the whole scene. I know what you mean. Nice, you can blend out absolutely every noise. Oh, that is hard to focus, yeah. Dang. I guess I could take this instead of having a tree here, I could make it a bush or a pillar. Or a static. Oh, a static would probably be best. Let's make that a static tile. Yeah, they'll kind of fake it so it looks better. All right, so that's in pattern rock face, I think. So those will all be statics, and these will all be bushes. Bushes can sometimes get transformed into trees by the algorithm, so that's why I set all these to be bushes, but one of them was a tree. So statics are empty inside, but they still have a collision area. So that'll make it so it doesn't have any crazy shadows doubling up here. Ooh, you're right. Genetic components? Whoa, what happened here? Why did the trees get on that side? Messed something up there! Oh, this is minus. I want that to be plus. Plus, minus, what's the difference? Plus, minus. Okay, the static tiles worked. All the static tiles worked, but there's no bushes. Oh, it's probably because we gotta put the bushes down first. Overriding tiles. Yeah. Yeah. Addiction, for sure. It's a powerful thing. I was reading about that, about how addiction, like I was reading about how a baby can be influenced by a mother. You know, if a mother is taking drugs or whatever, that the baby can be have a much stronger inclination towards brain abnormalities that would encourage addiction and other types of things like that, problems. Oh. This is just P.x plus 5 then. There. Wow, addiction's 50% genetics. Wow. Damn it, where'd the bushes go? What did I do? Why is this not working? Static is minus 2 to plus 5. Bushes are plus 6 to plus 8. Ay, 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 what did I do? This doesn't make sense. Whoa, you had to wear earplugs for exams? Man. Yeah, hopefully it's a room without clocks. I can't sleep with clocks. If I hear a clock ticking, I can't fall asleep. Maybe it's the override tiles. Seriously, this should work. I comment everything else out. Everybody hates the ticking. Yeah, you studied with white noise track? White noise track. Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah, whenever I need to focus, like if there's a lot of loud noise and things going on, I'll put on like meditation music and stuff on the internet. But that's actually a really good idea, just to put on some white noise. I've never tried that. This is such a mystery. These bush tiles are not appearing. This function is not working. It's gotta be this override tile thing. You play Rainforest or Rainstorm? Oh, yeah? Does it work? That's cool. Try to identify tropical bird. Which bird is this? And fight over. I'm sure. Oh, there they are. They're just for. Oh. Oh, God. The whole time. They were just too far. All right. So this needs to be plus. Four. Ish. This is awesome. Rockface is almost done. This is a new NPC. So that means Tuesday, tomorrow, I can work on some bug fixes. Wednesday, I can work on some more bug fixes and then publish an update to Steam. Yeah, there we go. We got some bushes over here. Some of them got converted into trees up there. Now we just got a nice clean shadow, even though the player isn't in shadow when he's back here. Guess I could work on that. But yeah, so then we got some static tiles behind here, which prevent you from... walking around back there and getting lost in the getting too lost, I guess. Is that too high, maybe? Okay, now this is all straight. Let's just make sure this all works in order again. Or out of order. I got none of them yet. Yes, good. It's playing the first dialogue. Did I edit the data? I'm not sure if I did. Ah, yeah, Frag did the wrong data. Okay, hold on. Rockface 2 requires item Sarira 2. Rockface 3 requires item Sarira 3 for that glow to appear. Now it should be okay. Okay, once again, let's do these out of order, just to confirm that they work sequentially no matter what. I'm gonna do number 2 first. Screen, come back on. Oh, damn it! Why didn't it work? Okay, let's see what data it saved. And also, I guess I should confirm what what rock face that was. That's probably the first thing to confirm after this data. Yeah, so it did the first rock face dialogue. Oh, it gave me the first rock face. Item. That's wrong. Okay, here's where it went wrong. First of all, let's go confirm what create NPC tile. Which one of these are you? None of the above? What? I don't believe it. I know it's creating one of those. Who are you? Which one are you? There, it did it that time. Okay, Rockface 2. Yeah, good. That's what I wanted. Good to know. Thank you. Thumbs up. Let's proceed. So why did Rockface 2 give me Sharira number 1? That's wrong. Okay, story nodes. Why would it do this? Rockface 1 has not Sharira 1. Give item Sharira 1. Oh, each one of these should have a separate name. And then that'll clear that up. So Rockface 1 is gonna have name Rockface 1. Same thing with 2 and 3 there. And then in their entity data here, I can just name this Rockface 3. So that way Rockface number 3 will always be associated with Sharira number 3. And vice versa for these other guys. Just make sure the data is all clean. No rock faces here. No Sariras. All right, let's do it again. Fleshing out the little bugs. These are all the little things that go into making an NPC the way you want it. This is an NPC. That's right. I said it. It's an NPC. It's a giant obelisk NPC. Did I edit these story nodes? I did. Exists Rockface 1. Exists Rockface 2. What happened? Just double check. Gotta make sure here. Yeah, we don't have any of those. Face. What happened? Hey, what's up, Kovarni? Welcome. Welcome to the stream, man. Today. I guess I'll turn on story verbosity, see if it's running the story action. I'm working on an NPC named Rockface. He's a big old obelisk, and you meditate next to him to communicate with, gain his knowledge and stuff. So I'm working on all the little details in the programming right now. So we still got zero there. It ran it. it totally ran it. And then it did that, and nothing happened. And it says it has 5 dialogue lines, but nothing is happening here. I pressed a button and even... Oh, what? What? Oh, I know what it is. Oh, okay. Okay, so the story nodes were all set to play on entity Rockface, and then Rockface changed his name to be Rockface 1, 2, and 3. So is there a better way to do that, maybe? I only want Rockface. Yeah, I know. This needs to be this way. Rockface 1. 1. I can't type. Nope. I can't freaking type. I'm like a professional programmer that can't type. What's with that? First of all, trying to call myself professional. That's funny. There. All right. Let this proceed. Let this actually all work. Kill the enemies. With what's DDR? Oh god, it didn't work again. Why god? Oh, I know you're here. Rockface 2 exists. Rockface 2. Rockface 2. All right, well, let's set a breakpoint. Dance Dance Revolution. Oh, good idea. Man, lots of little bugs with this, man. I thought I would be farther in one stream. Oh, 4 buttons for your feet? Okay. Does it get the dialogue lines? Let's check that. Yeah, it got dialogue. Well, that's right. Okay, pause all loops. Stop the characters from running. Oh, did I ever look at the ideas list? That's actually the ideas list for Bot Fu. That's like an idea like, hey, Bot Fu should be able to do this, or Bot Fu should be able to do that. It's frequently confused with ideas for the game Songbringer. Capture with light shot. Oh, nice, nice. Dance, dance. Dialogue is modal. Next dialogue line. Come on. Does it work? Here it is. Run to here. Okay, dialogue. Oh god damn, yeah, okay, that explains it. So we need to have all those. I have to have the guy always named Rockface. Pattern maybe? Okay, dang it. All right, so every one of these guys always has to be named Rockface. Not Rockface 1, 2, or 3. Same thing with the story, strings here. All these need to be Rockface. This is tricky. There's so many little things to get right. Having multiple entities that could play different sequential dialogue. There you go. That's a really good Bafu idea. Oh, no worries, no worries. Yeah, I mean, it's been done so many times. I'm not even sure if Boogie even looks at it either. He's like, they're not even Bafu ideas, really. Okay, so how to get these entities, so it can't ever run. Oh, maybe I could try a world pattern, or I mean a story node pattern. So it would be like, this would be has Serira, and you have to have pattern Rockface 1. Oh, and this is not exist Rockface 1, it's exist Rockface. Excuse me. Okay, I don't know if pattern is even a thing. Let me look at the world's Z matcher thing. World or pattern matcher? What is it? A focine. World matcher. I know it parses the pattern. Yeah, parse pattern. Okay, and then in the story system, story nodes, I think, are a child of world matcher. Let's make sure of that. Story node, where are you? Parse story nodes. Yeah, public world matcher. So can run, it needs to match Z, match style cards, match flags, has, hasn't, is, isn't, positions, quantity, exists, not exist, idle, uptime, near, defeated. I don't think any of these are patterns, but where was flag? Oh yeah, flags is there. Okay, so we need to match a pattern now. Match pattern. If node, okay, so if the pattern node.pat Yeah, at least no dot pattern is not equal to K pattern, none. And the area dot pattern equals no dot pattern, or is not equal to no dot pattern, then return false. Okay, we got it now this time. And we can take off flags interest now, since we're matching a pattern exactly. There's no need to match like world flags or whatever anymore. Okay, let's hope that works. One of these minutes, it's gonna work right. Finally. So this is the second rock face. He should give me the second Sharira, but he should give me the first dialogue. Yeah, oh, thank the good Lord. It worked. It worked. Long ago, blah, 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 blah. Item Sharira 2. Cool, we got it, yeah, yeah. And if I go off and come back, yes! He's still glowing! Yeah! Awesome. Okay, let's go to this other one. I'm still doing it out of order, so this is now number 3. And I want it to run dialogue number 2, and it's gonna give me item number 3. And if I walk off and come back on, it's just still glow and all that. Dialogue. It looks like the right item. Got 2 of those now. If I go off screen. Come back on. Still glowing. Boom. Wizard Poo, I need scissors. 61 scissors. What do you mean, Bafu? All right, last one, out of order. This all works now. My next steps are I'm gonna go check this in, and then tonight what I'm gonna do to finish Rockface is to finish this NPC completely is to work on the dialogue. So he's got a different dialogue component than other characters in the game because he's just like you're communicating with meditation or whatever. So that's why he's got that the words up on top and all that. So I want those words to appear a little slower. I want them to have a different sound. And I want them to have a little bit of inflection too. So the last word, for example, will have a slightly lower pitch of a little noise or whatever when it comes do 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 or like do 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 do, you know, something like that. Just to make it a little more interesting for dialogue. And that'll be it. That way he'll be all finished. So that's all for today's stream. Yep. Been a pretty productive stream. So thanks a lot, everybody. Thanks for watching. And I'll catch you next time. And once again, this will be up on Steam this Wednesday. So cheers, everybody.